Yet another sports star is being worshipped as a brave heroic icon while objectively being a massive failure. American gymnast Simone Biles branded herself the GOAT, the greatest of all time, after winning multiple gold medals. She entered the Tokyo Olympics as the de facto leader of Team USA. But all that changed when she made her first mistake. She was supposed to perform what they call an Anemar vault, which begins with a round off back handspring onto the table followed by two half twists in midair. But she only did one half twist instead. Instead of regrouping, refocusing, and going again, Biles immediately quit. She abandoned her teammates, who were left to carry on without her, and they ended up losing to the Russians.
You guys have trained your whole entire life for this. It's fine. I've been to an Olympics. I'll be fine. This is your first. You go out there and kick ass, okay?
USA Gymnastics initially claimed that Biles had a, quote, medical issue, but had to retract that when Biles herself said she just, quote, didn't feel right. After throwing her teammates under a competitive bus, Biles said, quote, I wanted it to be for myself, but I came in and felt like I was still doing it for other people. Biles subsequently blamed mental health issues and social media for her poor performance, quote, not having as much fun. There are a couple of days when everybody tweets you and you feel the weight of the world. We're not just athletes, we're people at the end of the day, and sometimes you just have to step back, she said. Sorry, what? You're an elite athlete training for and performing on the biggest stage in the world, and you're worried about tweets. It's like she got bored of winning gold medals and suddenly started craving social media sympathy dopamine as something more valuable. Despite her dubious reasons for quitting, the hashtag BeKindCrowd, you know, the type who routinely abuse and organise mob pylons of people who they disagree with, you know, because they're such nice, compassionate people, they instantly leapt to Biles' defence.
I support Simone Biles and Naomi Osaka. Their right to choose what's best for them is courageous and respectable.
They praised Biles for her courage and heroism, insisting that she was an inspiration to others, while denouncing anyone who dared to suggest that Biles was just making selfish excuses for herself, while bullying and shaming anyone who had the temerity to point out that deserting your friends and acting like a loser isn't heroic or courageous. We saw the same thing recently with tennis players Naomi Osaka and Emma Raducanu. We saw the same thing with the England footballers who missed the penalties. All were lionized as heroes for failing at the one thing they're supposed to be professionally trained for: handling pressure. Why is society redefining failure as bravery? In one sense, it speaks to this bizarre trend of shirking personal responsibility by immediately defaulting to emotional incontinence. But in another sense, it's part of the general pattern of social engineers flipping everything on its head to scramble our natural human inclinations. It's also part of the left's bastardization and colonization of language. As Leonidas Johnson summarized, cowardice is called courage. Failure is called success. Men are called women. Abortion is called healthcare. Racism is called anti-racism. Fascism is called anti-fascism. Opinions are called facts. Facts are called hate. Regressive is called progressive. Mental health has become a refuge from failure for people at all stations of society, right up to elite level athletes. Our culture has socially re-engineered everyone to think that breaking down into a blubbering mess at the first sign of trouble is brave and courageous. It isn't. Defiantly refusing to submit, even in the face of extreme adversity, that's brave and courageous. Crying and quitting because you messed up once isn't brave or courageous. Life is hard. Life is struggle. It's not meant to be easy. And I'd argue it's a damn sight harder for people who've lost jobs, businesses, missed funerals, haven't been able to see family members for over a year because of lockdown, than it is for multimillionaire sports stars who achieve global acclaim by hitting or kicking balls or jumping over a vaulting horse. Life is hard. That's why you're supposed to equip people with healthy thinking patterns that foster mental fortitude, an outlook that helps them deal with the bullshit that's inevitably going to arrive without curling up into a fetal position. By doing the exact opposite, we're setting young people up for a lifetime of weakness and misery. And this isn't some glib cliched pull yourself up by the bootstraps garbage. It's how you deal with and react to bad things that happen in life without turning into a neurotic mush. And I'm not saying mental illness doesn't exist. I'm saying that someone pretending to have mental health issues to hide failure, to hide the fact that they've got bad coping mechanisms, to hide the fact that they've got poor impulse control, isn't mental illness, it's an excuse. It's also an insult to people who suffer from genuine mental illness, which is outside of their control. You hear this all the time. There's a stigma around discussing mental health.
No, there isn't. People never shut up about it. It's never not being discussed.
Diagnosing yourself with a mental illness isn't a replacement for a personality.
Saying you're depressed or autistic, when in reality you're just lazy or boring, doesn't make you unique.
Society, thanks in large part to mobs of woke imbeciles, keeps valorizing failure as success and weakness as courage.
They use sports stars who mess up, such as Simone Biles, as the means to amplify this message.
And the sports stars are more than happy to embrace and broadcast that narrative, because it provides them an excuse to avoid the reality of admitting that they just weren't good enough.
But teaching young kids that being neurotic is normal, that weakness is strength, and that selfishness is responsibility isn't helping them at all.
It's not healthy, it's not positive, it's incredibly harmful to their cognitive development.
It's the exact opposite of the message that will help get them through life.
Stand up for yourself, don't let the bastards grind you down, and don't be a fucking crybaby when things don't go your way.
Thing is, when I talk about this, some people think I'm speaking some kind of alien language.
Well, I'm not.
It's called Stoicism. It's over 2,000 years old. Google it.
To get exclusive content, early access, behind the scenes stuff, and to personally interact with me, please sign up for my community at pauljosephwatson.locals.com. Link in description, and thank you for your generous support.